All right, today is a big day. It is one of the top days all year to start a diet, and lots of people in our community are offering support. Joining us now with What's in the Works is health anchor Liz Bonus. Liz.
Hey guys, good afternoon to you again. A former University of Kentucky and NFL quarterback inviting you to start a challenge with him to get back in shape. Jared Lorenzen launched the Jared Lorenzen Project, you may recall, a few years ago. As part of his journey to lose weight, he hosted fitness events like this one in Tower Park in Fort Thomas. Today, he is issuing a new six-week challenge on Facebook. He wants to open a discussion for others with weight issues to talk about exercise routines and diet options. The goal is to see a change by Valentine's Day. And since it is one of the top dieting days of the year, if you want to change a few habits, you might need to stop sabotaging your own weight loss. We need to go to our diet day graphic here. Do we have that? Here is how you want to do that.
Yeah, just get some stems off.
It's Veggie Stir Fry Day at the Recovery Center of Hamilton County. For Juliette Katenda,
I feel like nutrition is a very big part that could like make a benefit and improve like the body, the mind, and the soul.
She's right. If you want this year's changes to last, Maria Adkins, a registered dietitian, says stop sabotaging your own weight loss.
I think the biggest thing is to make small steps, you know, one at a time.
First up, rather than trying to give up everything you like all at once,
just make small steps that you think you can keep.
Second, pick one habit to tackle at a time. So maybe it's not food. It could be what you drink or your activity levels.
If you're drinking 5 or 6 sodas a day, to decrease by 1 soda per day and add a cup of water. Same with exercise, just to start out with just 10 minutes a day, perhaps even 5 minutes, you know, and add a minute each time.
Third, choose better foods, not a better diet.
Yeah. You know what I love is that you're kind of plant-based, and people a lot of times have been asking, do I have to do keto? Do I have to do high protein? You're
yeah.
like,
yeah.
And finally, meet up with others. Not having accountability can sabotage healthy habits too. This program, Eating Healthy on a Budget, certainly worked for Juliette and Kelly.
I find myself trying to eat healthier and like kind of like what Maria said, like drink more water and like think more about my choices.
She involves everyone. Everyone does, participates, and it's just a great environment.
And if you'd like to be part of that great environment, 513-241-1411. And you can find out more about participating in some of those healthy eating programs, healthy eating on a budget, or other programs at the Recovery Center. There is no charge for the programs, but you do need to meet certain criteria for mental health and wellness. Paula?
All right. Thank you, Liz.